Hello and welcome. My name is Kalad. We are resuming our stream of EU4. Well, not resuming, but hello and welcome.
There we go.
We are doing our sound check. That's what I was trying to say. So, last time we had a very interesting run as Alucaston going into the Moogles, and I thought the Timurids were weak, so I could launch an assault on them, and then they brought like 60,000 troops, went into quite a bit of debt, and I just kind of cried and left the stream. So, what we're gonna do is generate a new random new world, and we're going to restart that run. Again, it's not because that run would have. I could still play that run if I wanted to. It's just that I really want to one tag this as the Moogles, and for that, I'm gonna have to be selective with how I continue. The reason I want to do a one tag is because, well, I think I've mentioned a few times, it's been a little while since I've done it. I haven't done a world conquest or anything since my Three Mountains run. So, Moogle Reich 02, start Iron Man. I mean, I could always take the easy way out and go Delhi and culture swap, but I've been doing a lot of culture flipping, a lot of culture swapping, flipping, however you want to say it, recently. So yeah, I want to limit it to about as much as I can, honestly, with the culture flipping. But yeah, let's see here. Protect trade in the Indus, since that is our home trade node, who hates us. Send Kathiawar and Oman, which means Multan's available. Multan would be a swell ally to have. And who hates Send? What do you know? Multan and Mawar. Mawar, I'm going to want to incorporate in my country as soon as I possibly can. Gujarat is someone I am going to want to go to war with in the near future. But yeah, let's see here. Send, I don't like you. Oman is someone I'm going to want to destroy sooner than later. But yeah, we're going to have some choices to make. Send, fabricate on Thada. And my other rivals. Kathiawar would make a nice rival to have. Multan for whenever we eventually decide to break it off, which won't take too long. So yeah, Send is someone who I'm going to want to get inside my country sooner than later. I have a terrible king. Not a half bad general, still pretty bad. Fort maintenance, do I still have fort maintenance? And, yeah, Multan, we're gonna improve those relations because, well, Multan would be great to use against Delhi. Multan and Jaunpur against Delhi? Fantastic. So, Multan is going to make a, nice little, ally of mine for a bit. And, yeah, ally is the word there. So I'm not gonna be able to vassalize them anytime soon. So, my army limit can go up to 8. We'll be getting another infantry. And put you there. And yeah, let's get more ships. Cause ships are good. Delhi is allied with Sindh now. Bit unfortunate. But it is what it is. Once I am able to ally Molton, I can get my glorious, I can get my diplomat back and try to become friends with Jean Poor, who hate Malwa, and the feeling's mutual. They also hate Deli, and Deli's my main target to begin with. So the dream here is rip Molton. Yeah. Well, Molton would have been a great ally to have. Deli is still willing to be my friend. We'll improve your relation ever so slightly. And we'll take you back. Because, well, we want to go to war with Molton. Now, not that I actually not that Valid casts Belly. So, yeah, that's not happening, I guess. Temerid's Destroy Molton is a great way to snipe it, but minor details. So big thing is, if I can... Hello, no. That's the, wrong thing there. I want to fabricate the claim. And if Sen goes on the offensive against Molton before I do, and that's just not good for me. But yeah, Sen and then going and getting this border with Deli would be ideal, honestly. Oh yeah, I want to switch this. Change government. I want to go to a tribal despotism. Because I'm not a fan of this. Yeah, it's just straight up gross. Oh yeah, also, military focus. Let's demand that military support and call it it. Merchant guilds, I really want your ducats. But you don't want to give them to me. Oh well. So yeah, right now it's just chilling. We fabricate this claim. Molton is about to die very painfully. And the downside about going to war with Molton while the Temerids are at war with them would be Temerids could very well just vassalize them. I'd have a very scary person that would want to attack me. But yeah. Dream is that we find some way to go to war with Deli against Molton without it being suicidal. And then be able to go to war with Send. Fabricate on between these two, we will fabricate on Sewan. The ideal because it has higher development and so it'll cost more to core. Thada was the other big one I was caring about. Yeah, Molton is gone. Well, they still have a fully maintained fort at level 2. That's. Yeah, I was afraid that was about to happen. Not good. Not good at all. Sen just got another ally, right? No. So, decisions. Wait. Do not get discovered. Okay. Yeah, we're gonna have to figure this out. So. Stability, I'm really tempted to do, just because I don't like being a negative one. Five prestige is fine with me. So, a bit expensive at that. But it's okay. Rival for rival is Mawar, who's someone I really don't want to care that much about. And improve our prestige. Timurids are not hostile with me. That's interesting. Kara would be kind of nice to get as a friend to ward off the Timurids. As much as I could do that. But, yeah, chances of that happening are rather slim right now. I really want to save my money up, but at the same token, I need to get this fleet on the go. Because, yeah, having Delhi as a, yeah, having Delhi as Sin's ally is not good, so Multan is threatened by them, they would give access. Yeah, Delhi would be easily able to get access. So, I just have to find another person to go to war with Delhi against, or Delhi with, but that's not really happening. Unless I take this opportunity to pounce on the Timurids, who are going to war with Uzbek, and it's just them. I can get Delhi in to join. I get Delhi to join me against the Timurids, and just because I can promise them land from Multan, and that's possibly winnable, actually. Since you know they're distracted. Ro would be a territory I'd want, and Sin Sagar would also be a great. These three provinces would be the ones I'd want. And what do you know, this claim is almost up. We need the piety for that morale. And are you loyal or disloyal? They are loyal. Which means Timurids. How are you doing there, buddy? You are, in fact, committed to Uzbek. This could, again, be very suicidal on my end, but no risk, no reward, right? Delhi would definitely be willing to join. Yeah, we're gonna go home at war. So are you. 'Cause, yeah. Nash would be a bit of a problem. What is the Timurid's navy strength at, anyways? Navies. I mean, like, this is turning out to be somewhat similar to what I just experienced. I don't know. To risk it or not is the very question here. On the one hand, it would be great if, I could go to war with the Timurids, especially when you consider they're going to have Persian separatists soon. And if we go to war with them, we're going to have to deal with Nash and Nogai. But Nogai has their own issues. And Nash, well, how are you really wanting to join in on this war, buddy? Very close to not wanting to. If we give you that alliance, would you want to? That's a real question. Timurids, Nash, still attitude towards enemies. Yeah. I have to debate about this. Let's wait a year. Or not a year, let's wait a month. Because, yeah, Nash is still joined. The guy is getting very tempted not to join. Which, yeah, we're going to want to wait on that bit. Same token. War against Uzbek. Defender against Timurids. Yeah, this is a tough question. Grapple with, but the key point is I would be able to get Delhi in this. And that's really the big one. No risk, no reward. But we're gonna wait for Nagai to get out. It won't take them too long to want to not join this war. There we go. So, Delhi. Yes. Let's go to war here. And we'll deal with these consequences if and when they show up. Alright. Declare war. So yeah. Delhi, buddy. That also reminds me of my diplomatic feedback. I would really like to have these provinces. Delhi, you can take your core as much as I'd rather you not have it. But it is what it is. Alright. September 1st. Don't particularly want you staying in this. So yeah. You guys just run home. Delhi, buddy. Alright, they should be in this war. Good. Okay. So yeah, now we just have a little bit of fun. Well, this is going to be interesting. Okay. So, if we can maybe get there in time, it'll be interesting. Yeah. Well, we have Delhi's troops to throw at the Timurids. Interesting how this. Oh, wait, no. Okay. So, yeah. Slowly but surely, we are sieging up Multan. And we have a lot of troops. A lot of troops. Awesome. And, yeah, Multan's about to be completely occupied. And once we win this fort, like so, we can go and deal with this. I don't particularly want them to... Yeah, I do not want them all to be able to group up like that. Alright. So, Timurids have peaced out with Uzbek. That is not good. Because, you know why that's not good? Because it means Timurids are going to bring their full might to me. Which is not good one bit. Alright. Timurids, I'm sure we can be reasonable here. Right? Of course, right. So yeah, Timurids having that amount of troops on my capital is not quite the best. Especially consider they're no longer distracted by a foreign war. 322, it's right below average. Oh well. So, hopefully we can not die a terrible death like that. Well, this will be interesting to see if we can actually win this. Yeah, no, I didn't think we could. So, Delhi. Let's retreat. retreat back to your land. Your land's nice. And yeah, my capital is about to fall, which is not quite good. Length of war, relative strength of alliances is quite big. Losing my capital is not the greatest. Could be worse. And yeah. Go big or go home, and this is what could potentially happen if you go by that logic. Oh well. Things do happen. So, what are they doing? Alright. Gonna want to liberate my capital. And I'm gonna want to go pick these off as soon as I can. Cause yeah, farmlands are not quite good for me. Don't have a military tech advantage anytime. We won't be getting one anytime soon, unfortunately. Yeah, let's pick these guys off in farmlands. First and foremost. Or, let's do this instead, since this way we could get at least our full forces up. And yeah. 24th. 23rd. Alright. Can hopefully just destroy this force. That's the dream. The dream, of course, being the operative word. Alright. Awesome. So, you guys. Let's go take these guys out and not deal with this terribleness. Oh god, this is gonna hurt. February 17th? Yeah, this is really gonna hurt. Yeah. Really gonna hurt. Thing is, I don't really want you guys to back up here, because, well, we're going to want to get out of that if at all possible, but it's not possible at all, as you can see, because hordes, with that nice buff of theirs. Alright, so at this point, the Persians are rising against their tyrannical overlords here of the Timurids, which is nothing but good for me when it comes down to it. I'm going to want to get some more troops as soon as I can, but I don't really want to go too much on my way for it, honestly. So, you guys are not quite willing to. Oh, come on, Deli. Help a guy out. Alright. Oh, gotta do everything myself, it looks like. Just gonna have to take that loan, unfortunately. The reason being, we need to get more troops. And pronto. Oh, come on, Deli. You know you want to give me Sin Cigar. Who cares if you have a claim on it? Yeah. Yeah, the dream here is that you don't get slaughtered like you are. Thanks, Deli, for breaking off there, bud. Alright. So, hopefully, Deli will actually start being a little bit intelligent and just attaching to where I say attach. That's really what matters here. Oh dear, this is gonna hurt. I just know this is gonna hurt a lot. A lot. Yeah, like a wipe all of my troops off a lot. Yeah, Timurids are not that fun to play with right now. Oh. When in doubt, build more troops. Because, yeah, this is a very painful. This is going to be very painful. Deli, please just attach. Now then, the real question's gonna really come on. Leave me alone. Oh well, you're going after the 1K stack, I see. All right. Well, we can try your way. Your way is going to fail miserably, and I'm going to die as a result of this. Wonderful. That's what happens when you help friends. Nothing good. So yeah, Persian Separatist. Now is your time to feel liberated. Why don't you feel liberated? Relative strength of alliances is somewhat calming down. But yeah, we're just going to really need to get our capital back. And fast. Okay. And as much as I really don't want to take more loans, I'm going to have to. Not going to have any cavalry, which is going to be very not good. But I can't exactly afford them either. Which is a bit of the problem. I need the morale, and I don't want to lose the admin power. We need the skills. Yeah. So, Ardalan. Ardalan is manageable. Delhi is definitely looking to get out of this. Which is not good, because if Delhi leaves, then I lose this war. Yeah, if Delhi leaves, I lose. This war should not be good. Well, we will have the advantage here. As much as I would rather not have this terribleness. But it is what it is. We're going to have to really hope that we can have some inspired generalship. And be able to retake my capital. Because, yeah, if we can retake my capital, then we can peace out of this war. Because, yeah, taking my capital back is... Oh, Delhi, with your two siege general. Thank you. Delhi and their two siege general is possibly going to save this for me. And yeah, we just have to hope that with his two siege, we can beat Moulton's two siege. Or they can ditch it to go liberate Moulton itself. Okay. So yeah, hopefully the Timurids are still having a rebel problem. And yes, Delhi is coming back to save me, hopefully. Delhi, please. You are literally our one shot at liberating my capital. Don't ditch me like this, man. And I get the feeling that, yep, the Temerids are coming knocking. This is gonna be painful. I doubt I could win that. I'm serious doubt about being able to win that one. Oh well. Oh, hey. I had that on check at some point. Wonderful. Okay, Deli. We'll play it your way. Just hope beyond hope that we can take Ro. Then go liberate my capital again. Cause you know what would be great? Liberating my capital. So I'm not digging this war exhaustion. Peace offer of a white peace, do I be greedy? That's the real question. To take Ro, we should be able to demand quite a bit more. Cause yeah. Deli, what's your war participation? 65%. You're not getting 65% of this land. I really don't care if you're pissed at me, truth be told. Cause well, I'm gonna have to gun you down. But yeah, these two provinces would be quite ideal. This so I can get a glorious vassal in Punjab. Alright. Okay. And I could take this. Ghazni would be just another nice province to have. That gets me closer to Ro. Same token. Yeah. Didn't think you'd be willing to give me that. But that'd have been nice if you would have. Oh well. And 14 ducats for my trouble, which I get 5 of. And I completely screwed Deli out of everything. Perfect. Alright, Deli. How much do you hate me? Trust is at 30. Okay. Oh dear god, that is some terrible, terrible war exhaustion. The other thing is, I'm really going to, release the subject of Punjab. Here's my question. You're going to be Hindu because... Okay. Hindu is a fine, fine religion, and I really wish I could be one. Punjab is fine. With me. Goodbye, that. Goodbye, Diplo Power. I knew you well. Doesn't even scratch the surface of how much I need that. Okay. I don't care if Delhi breaks their alliance with me, honestly. The big thing is that Malwa is getting trounced. I should have been improving relationships with Shahanpur though. That was quite dumb of me to not do that already. But it's okay. I can be in some relative safety. Alright. You guys are still mothballed, good. You go to the Indus. And off we go. Kathiawar is no longer a valid rival for me. Who would be a valid rival? Deli? Don't mind if I do. Alright. Shampoor. Mabara. I don't even care if the Timurids have warned me, honestly. But yes, Jangladesh would be a really nice claim to take, and have Jaunpur as a very good friend. Friend for a little while to go against, you know, the Delhi menace. So yeah, hopefully they will turn friendly at some point. In the meantime, we really are just going to have to not pay our troops and chill. Because yeah, if I go to war against Delhi, then they'll bring Send in, which two birds, one stone, all that jazz. And I'm really going to need to get my glorious manpower back up. And yeah, these peasants are not gonna be pleasant to deal with if I have to deal with them. Miltech 4 would be a really big thing to be able to use against my nemesis. Yeah. Hey, Lima. Yeah, these peasants would not be fun to deal with. Okay, Timurids did manage to deal with their rebel problem, it looks like. Unfortunately. But it's okay. Slowly but surely, we can just let all of our terrible war exhaustion go down. Oh god, that is so far away. Alright, we're gonna have to pay our troops so we can have a chance of beating these stupid peasants. Alright, we're gonna have to defend our capital. So if you guys could politely get over to our capital, that'd be great. But yeah, Jaunpur should be my friend in the near future. Okay, and Jaunpur is decimating Malwa. Where is Kuron? My autonomy with these is already very high, for reasons. Yeah, sure. Alright. Jaunpur should hopefully enter into alliance with me. Yes. Wonderful. Alright, now I've got a good buddy to smack Delhi with. Alright, well, this is not going to be fun. Well, apparently we did manage to beat those peasants there. But yeah, this is not fun at all. Okay, so they have cavalry. I do not. I have a general. They do not. So yeah, so long as they do not go to Chagai, I'll be fine. Because yeah, these mountains are going to be a pain. Charity for the poor? Of course, see to it. Alright. You guys are coming to me in the mountains. That's fine with me. Even though they do have a cavalry and I do not, I still outnumber them and I have mount bonus. More than fine with me. And that's how you deal with peasant revolts. Oh dear god, this is gonna take a long time for this war exhaustion to take down. Just hopefully it will just continue Hopefully I'll be able to deal with it sooner than later. But Send. Who does Delhi even have as allies? Bengal, Send, and Nagar? Gore? Bengal that has been chomped. Jampur still is very, very strong. Which is fine with me. And yeah. Don't really want to use all my manpower in infantry, but I'm gonna have to right now. What time is it? Okay. Yeah, I should probably do my spiel at some point. Anyways, if you like the content, hit that follow button. If you like the content on, if you like the stream, hit that follow button. If you like my content over YouTube, please hit like and subscribe. I'm a fan of feedback. I really haven't gotten much. By much, I mean none at all. So yeah, that would obviously be ideal to be able to get at some point some feedback. But I understand. People don't really like to do that kind of stuff. Why is my starting autonomy so high everywhere? Interesting. Okay. Yeah, alright. Well, my starting autonomy is high, which is one reason why I'm very, very poor. And yes, who else do I want to have as an ally? Who else hates Delhi? Just myself. Who hates Jampur? Bengal and Delhi. Vijayanagar, how are you doing, bud? Well, who all hates Sindh? Mewar, Baluchistan, Jad. Kathiawar, Mewar. Mewar is someone I don't really care too much about, but. Eh. You know what? Let's just do that. Because Mewar is at least someone else I can throw warm bodies at people for. Ottomans have announced the Timurids as their new rival. Oh, well, that's good. The Ottomans, who have already taken an early bite out of the Mamluks. Alright. So yes, Punjab would obviously be really nice to get some cores back from, however, to become my glorious nation here. We're gonna need Lahore, which is a Punjab core. Sirhind, Delhi, and Central Doab, which is these are all the provinces I need. And a wonderful thing about my vassal is that it has cores on every single province I need. Except for, well, as on a lot of them, I'll put it that way. Alright. So yeah. We will see how this goes. Let's see here. Mewar. Okay, Jampur. I'm gonna wait this one more month. Then I'm gonna take you back. Because I need to get this claim fabricated on Jingladesh. Because, well, you know what I need? I need a glorious ally here. Well, I need a glorious claim to go to war against Delhi. Because in one war, I can take pretty much everything I need from Delhi. Well, I can take quite a bit that I want from Delhi. And, yeah, to really capitalize on this, I would have to bolt my troops to Delhi itself, unless I can get military access. to where I need to go. Would you be willing? You would not be too hard to do it from. All right, and I can do that. Yeah, I like merchant guilds, and who really cares about legitimacy? Not this guy. Man, that was kind of dumb for me to withdraw that merchant then. Or not merchant, but diplomat then. Alright, so... Dundahar, you need to be incorporated into the realm. I mean, yeah, I'm paying a little bit more than I should for coring those, because my war exhaustion is so high, but I really need to get those cores on the go. Military technology has gone up, which is nice. You guys, oh god. Well, Delhi's in a regency. What's my truce like with Delhi? Another couple years. So yeah. Have another couple years to go until I can even go to war with Delhi, so nothing really to worry about. Have my 8,000 men. Army maintenance, go back down. And if I am able to, yeah, I just really want to be able to form Mughals sooner than later. Kara would be a great ally to get at some point. Not that it's going to happen anytime soon, but... Okay, Mawa just dishonored a call to arms against Bakmanis, who... Gujarat is carving into Tranquil, nobles, emirs. Gain a lot of loyalty. Or I can, but I lose a base tax in Khalid, which is there. Don't really want that, but I also don't want that. It's a bit of a problem. Probably a bit of a problem. I mean, it's like a really big problem. I'm gonna have to do it, unfortunately. So, 0.06 ducats out the window. Which is wonderful. Yeah, not having any of these claimed is gonna be quite terrible for the aggressive expansion. But that's okay. But yeah, our manpower's recovering, we're just chilling out for 2 years, waiting for, we're gonna let our war exhaustion tick down, we're gonna wait for these cores to finish, get our manpower up, get our money up, and all that wonderfulness. And yes, Punjab should hopefully be a great... Oh, they're improving relations with me. That's cool. But yeah, hopefully, hopefully I can just get some, decent things going here for me. Ask for military access, yes. Gonna be over the Diplo limit just temporarily. Ask for military access, wonderful. What? Ask for military access, awesome. And Jean-Paul, ask for military access. Now I can go about and cancel all these accesses. Cancel. Piety is the better way to go right now. Dundahar, don't need your access anymore. Alright. And cancel military access there. So no longer too many diplomatic relations, which is good. Yeah, I've got to wait for that to take down anyways. Malar, how are you feeling about alliance, buddy? Not feeling it, because I have too many diplomatic reputation. No, I don't have too many diplomatic relations in your factoring. Alright. So yeah. Dream right now is just to chill until our war against Delhi, where we will let our good friends, Jean-Paul, destroy everything for me. Delhi itself is something I'm going to want. Because, yeah, the big dream here is I'm just gonna really need to be aggressive with what exactly it is that I'm granting. I'm gonna be pretty aggressive with what exactly it is I'm gonna be giving to my people. I don't want these guys revolting, even though it's from my better provinces. Its autonomy's not too high. No, his autonomy is high. This guy's. So I gotta get much more out of it, but I could is a thing. Yeah, we'll give this to you guys. Because, well, I get a lot of tax out of it. And let's see here. How much longer do I have? Oh, hey, it expires in 2 months. So, Jean-Paul, buddy. Two favors. Okay. My military tech will be quite nice. Oh, wonderful. That just now ended. Okay. All right. So we'll go ahead and do that. And importing iron, 60 military power or mercantilism. I want the mercantilism. Yeah. How many times can I get that event, right? Right. And declare war. Jean-Paul. I recently broke a promise to grant land, so you won't join me because that totally was for you. That's irritating. Sedate the old gems. Yep, I'm streaming. How are you doing, sir? So yeah, this is rather unfortunate. I'm gonna have to look up, see how long this actually takes to dissolve. Let's see here. Recently. No, I am not surprised that you have all that. Any idea what the cooldown is on a recently dishonored, whatchacallit? Recently broke promise to give land. Promise to give. Any idea what the cooldown is on that? Because for some reason I'm getting that modifier on a nation that I did not break promise. Yeah. Let's see here. But yeah, anyways, any idea how long I'm going to need to wait for recently broke promise to give land modifier to go away? Let's see here. Oh, wonderful. 30 years. Wonderful. Well, that's kind of unfortunate. So my, so yeah, now I'm kind of on hold until I get enough favors with Jean-Paul to go to war with Delhi. Because, you know, reasons. I mean, hey, I just told Delhi I'd give them land when I didn't and broke their alliance. And, yeah. So, slowly but surely, we are going to just have to wait on this. Ugh, sack. Okay. Our question is, can I threaten war with anybody? Send. I know you want to give me land. Threaten war? Yeah, I was figuring you wouldn't. I can't do that to an OPM. Multan. I can't as your subject. Temerence. Yeah. Well, can't really threaten war with anyone. Unfortunately. Eh. Who all do you hate? I could know CB Bing. No, because then you still wouldn't join. Because reasons. Yeah, okay. That did finish. Awesome. Afghan separatist, I'm not really wanting to deal with them. They go up to 90%, then I will just raise that autonomy. I like that. Yeah. Raise autonomy, and yeah. Wait a little while anyways. I'm gonna hope that they don't actually rise off of that glorious small percent chance they have. You're a little bit more risky here. But it's okay. So yeah. Timurids is yeah, the Timurids have decided, or my truce with the Timurids is over. So yeah, if Timurids want to go to war with me, that's fine. I'm not worried. And yeah. Let's fabricate a claim on these guys, just so I've got options. Yeah. No way. Oh, speaking of which, I'm really dumb. I meant to change to tribal nepotism long ago. Minus 15% at Empire rank? Wow. Well, that's nice. But you also don't get any minus autonomy is the other problem, though. But yeah. So, my good friend Jean-Paul, how long do I have to get more frickin' favors with you? Oh god. Why do you hate yourself? Every province to clergy, you no longer have to deal with rebels, you know, to convert quite a bit. Definitely not a bad idea. There was something. There was a reason why I opened this. Oh yeah, repay all loans. Screw loans. Book burning. Yeah, don't invite me. That's a problem. There's a dream that eventually this terrible guy will die, and I can get a less terrible person in charge. Not a realistic dream, but it's a dream. Come on. If that stupid 30-year thing wasn't there for Jean-Paul when I didn't even do that to them. Oh, wonderful. So yeah. Yeah, it doesn't surprise me at all. And then you also get the glorious 100 admin every 20 years. Base, is that due to, is Manipur, speaking of which, they have expanded much beyond their, initial ambitions. Proud of that, proud of the little animus guy. Yeah, that doesn't surprise me, that's actually pretty strong. Yeah. Declare war. Jean-Paul, Pless, you know you want to go to war with me. This is a wonderful modifier. Fun interactive gameplay. Right here live. Yeah, we'll wait on this. So yeah, so much for this, so much for doing any of this anytime soon. Ottomans at their strong 5 tech. And yeah, slowly but surely, we will generate favors with the Jean-Paul. I'm really, like, it's 3 development and desert, but I don't want to move my troops back over. So, rip whatever I was getting from that. You know, Delhi is someone I want to kill, but it won't be anytime soon, unfortunately. We could get a cavalry. Huh. Trying to think, there's no way to switch tribal government, right? So you couldn't be, you couldn't do Ottoman, Hindu tribal despotism. It's interesting. But yeah. Sure, we'll put a single cavalry there. Well, yes, but... Oh yeah, no, Moogle switches me to a, Ikta, yeah. Ikta. Iguana. Switches me to an Iguana government type. That's what we're going with, it's an Iguana government type. Alright. We should probably fabricate more claims on something like Timurids. Timurids are a very not friendly people. So yeah, we'll throw these guys with, yeah, like prestige. We'll throw you guys over to Punjab. Okay, losing the diplo relation penalty be. Yeah, that makes it really, really good then. But yeah, I don't know. I mean, when do you actually get autonomy reduction? I mean, that would. I don't know. I see it going both ways just because it's gonna make economic and much better. It's gonna make economic more important idea group to get if you're staying tribal despotism. But you're not really gonna be able to get. Never. Sorry, I don't even remember what I was talking about. I'm clever like that. But yeah. Oh yeah, never take economic ideas. Makes sense. I don't know. You'd be able to take economic like fifth, but I've got other. I'd want to take something else at that point. This is really, really boring having to wait for. So stupid that because I broke my promise of land to Delhi, that I can't keep Jaunpur. I can't make Jaunpur come in with me. I mean, yes, you can get. Good point about the full tax income, but the thing is, if you really want to make mad money, it's about. I mean, trade you don't lose a whole lot with, but I'm a big believer in production. And, yeah. You kind of get neutered hard for not having autonomy when it comes to production, which, I mean, it's going to make taxation a lot better. When it comes down to it, so yeah, I don't know. There are pros and cons to all of it. But yeah, all I want to do is form the Mughals, and I could have acted on this a lot sooner if, you know, I didn't have. God, okay, I remember there's of course something I was forgetting. Stupid Hormozzi collection merchant. I want to collect from trade here. Good point. However, there's still a you still have to wait. You still have there's still a you still have to have at least 5 development to switch it over to merchant guilds, right? In which case, if it's 5 development, then if it's less than 5 development, then why do you care about putting about if it's production or not, which is a valid point. Yeah, no, definitely not a bad idea. Oh yeah, you saw Marco broke the record again, right? Like, Jesus, I swear Marco's a robot. He has to be a robot at this point. Hormoz, I don't like you. I don't like Oman meme. That's definitely not a bad idea. I'll probably give it a shot on this run. Oh, who's his rival? /1544 World Conquest by 1.16. Okay, I'm a little. Okay, I'm curious on this one. He barely got sub 1600, and that was after. I don't know. I don't know if I'd still consider him the same level as Marco. Just because. Like, I mean, it's very. Don't get me wrong, what he did was extremely impressive. But the same token, I don't know, it seemed like he honed it a lot more than Marco did, truth be told. But yeah, I don't know. The guy impressed me at this Norwegian wood. At one point, whenever Common Sense came out, but he barely got sub 6. If I remember correctly, he barely got sub 1600. Like, wasn't it 1590s? Still very impressive, but I don't know. I don't know if he. I honestly, because that was like a very perfected run by Sarah. At least from what I gathered reading his stuff, he honed that, and that was like his best effort. The fact Marco still crushed it by like 20-ish years at least kind of makes me think it's not really an eligible rival when you consider Marco. I don't know. It didn't seem like Marco was really trying super hard to hone it down to that kind of perfection level. Oh yeah, no, the reason why his Norway campaign impressed me is because he was the guy who kind of started that whole fast revocation stuff. Oh, what time is it? 9:20. Should probably go to bed soon because I'm old and have work. One day I will get favors. Every 2 years, oh buddy. Okay, so Jean-Paul went to war with Delhi. Interesting how this works. And what do you know? You know who'd be great to go to war against Delhi with now? This guy. Alright. What at the second? Alright, we can't hesitate. We've got to go to war with Delhi at this point. Alright. Okay. Who cares that I'm going to be really screwed when it comes to my home front? Oh yeah, no, I completely agree with that. It's just, yeah, no. It was just I went to war against Timurids with Delhi, since Timurids had gone to war against Uzbek, and I promised Delhi land to get them in, and that was really annoying because you have a 30-year cooldown. Wasn't even ally with Jean-Paul at the time. Still got the stupid broke promise to give land recently modifier. I'm not salty by that at all. Anyways. If I go to war here, then Jean-Paul can have a free path to go wreck send for me. And, yeah, I do not want Jean-Paul getting any of my rifle land. Because, yeah. Whoa. You attacked Bengal. Well. This is a bit of a twist. So yeah, this is not gonna be fun. Yeah, that's not gonna be fun at all. I'm going to get wrecked. Oh, hey, what do you know? I was totally paying attention there. Let's retreat this way, my friends. Yeah, this is not going to be fun. Yeah, not good. That said, my trade fleet is bigger than all of Sin's fleet, so I don't really have to worry about it. Okay. Yeah, I'm gonna get... Yeah, I should have paid a little bit closer attention there. That was really dumb of me to not pay closer attention. It's gonna cost me. Because, yeah, I need 9 troops. I don't have 9 troops. So we could do this. And bleed some money. But it's kind of what we're going to have to do. A bit unfortunate. Alright. Gain piety. Really, the only saving grace I have is if Jean-Paul kind of goes and wrecks everything for me. Okay. Don't take this one stupid piece of land, you whore. Okay, thank you. Oh, hey, I was not paying attention to that at all either. Oh well, I'm about to get overrun. In my homeland, but YOLO. Alright. So yeah. This is not gonna be fun for me. Cause I was not paying close enough attention. Per usual. Yeah, and this is about to hurt. A lot. I don't have a chance of winning this one. September 29th. Yeah. Alright. Time to face the music and die. But yeah. Dream is just that Jean-Paul can go and wreck Deli's forces for me. Like the good buddies that they are. Okay. Good buddies that they are. The only thing I could possibly do right now to salvage this would be to peace out Nagar real quick and go snipe Send. Leave Jean-Paul to, that's gonna risk letting Jean-Paul get Delhi provinces. Provinces they really do not need to get. Oh, this is not gonna be pleasant. Well, maybe it will be. We'll see. Okay. Oh dear, oh dear, this is gonna hurt. This is gonna hurt. Why do I let bad things happen to me like this? Okay. You guys just retreat here. Alright. So, good old buddies. Oh god, now. Now, please don't hurt me. Please don't hurt me. Why? Okay, so we can't retreat this way, unfortunately. Alright. So this is gonna be painful. Very, very painful. Leave me alone. Send. Leave me alone. Now. Oh, this is not going to be fun. Alright. So. Goodbye. As you can see, pro strats right there. Alright. And time to tank my economy yet again to win a war. Okay. And then we can do this. Because, yeah, if I can just get Sen to, if I can get Sen to peace out of this war, then, yeah. Essentially, I'm going to have to get Sen to peace out. And, have that happen rather fast. Please don't tell me they've, no. No, they declared war against Bengal. So, that's where I'm spooked. God, this is going to be so painful. Alright. Hi, Sentinagor. This will not be fun. Well, on the one hand, they are coming down this way. On the other hand, this stuff. Oh, hey, I was totally thinking I was off pause. So, can I win this? Probably not. Am I gonna try? Probably. Come on. Yeah, I'm still probably going to lose. Nope. Calculated. Alright. So the dream here is, well, what do you know? I lucked into Miltech 5. I knew it was going to be released soon. I just didn't know how soon. Charge cavalry, I like a bit better. I think. Easy game. Alright. So, yeah, this is how we're gonna do this. Oh, hey, I'm pretty sure it's lost a merc as a result of this. Oh, well. Yeah, in fact, I did. Yeah, well. Maybe two mercs. Who's keeping track?
But yeah, my vassal was about to get occupied by Nagor. And in the meantime, okay, Jean-Paul, please just wreck stuff for me. And, well, my vassal actually has a pretty decent general there.
A lot better than mine.
So, yeah, if I can get Send out of this, then I can easily get Nagor out of this. Then I can focus on Delhi, but by that point, Jaunpur is probably already going to take another core that I'm going to want. Of course. Come on. Maintain. Yeah, that's not bueno. Ouch. Yeah, we're gonna need the stability at least. Okay. So, Jangladesh has become a loyal vassal of Delhi at this point. Interesting. Oh, thank God my vassal is helping me out here. Good vassal. I take Sin's capital, I can probably piece them out for their capital. Deli, leave me alone. Please, just leave me alone. You know you want to. Thank you. Awesome. Send. Really now? Eh. It was a bit of a pipe dream, but it was a dream. Alright. Let's keep my vassal attached to me right here. Because, yeah, now my vassal attached, so I can hopefully knock Sin down a peg or two. Come on. Thank you. I realize your capital is completely destroyed, but that's okay, because it's not my problem. Yeah, losing an extra merchant ship isn't the greatest, but eh. Yeah, so we're just gonna have to, Oh, of course, you gotta be greedy. Yeah, no, that astrary is way too good. But yeah, no, the dream is that I can go and knock out Send before, you know, they take my capital. Not that that's realistically going to happen, but it's a dream. I should probably relocate my capital to Drylands and build a fort on it at some point. Oh, Send, stop. Oh, this is not going to be pleasant. I already see where this is headed. Oh, sweet. The Gore have their own problems. Now, your capital is under siege and you're going after me. That's called dedication right there. Okay, Send is at Miltech 4 still. And they're about to hurt me. Something first. Yeah, there's a dream I could actually win this. Yup. Easy. Easy game. Easy. No, Dally, stop. It just never ends. I could white piece them. Yeah, this is where it's gonna really hurt. Alright. So. Yeah. Deli, leave me alone, plus. This hurts. I want to take Sin's estuary so bad, but I can't. Oh man, this is painful. Cindy war exhaustion. The thing is, once my capital falls, I can't peace Send out probably. Bit of a problem, but whatever. 18 ducats is 18 ducats. And, yeah, we can go with this. So, yeah. Nagore is gonna be a bit of a problem at some point. Probably. Yeah, the real dream is to, get up to 10,000 infantry. Okay. And I'm getting hunted down by Deli, because Deli are whores like that. In the meantime, we're just going to retreat to these glorious mountains. And have Deli leave us alone. Really?
Alright. Let's do this. Bring it. No leader. Get wrecked that 9-3. Oh, come on, seriously? Seriously. How does that even happen? Screw you, Deli. Screw you. Alright, so, here's what I have to do. You guys are gonna go to Kalut. My mercs to scrunch up here. And you guys. Consolidate one. You guys want to get rid of some infantry. And yeah. We're going to take some loans out because, you know, loans have never hurt me before. Alright. So, what we're going to do is get more mercs. Get ourselves up to that 10 force limit. I'm going to have to cancel that one. The dream here is we can do this. Hopefully in time. Alright, now die. Please just die. No. You leave my vassal's capital out of this. Alright. Yeah, it was not my smartest attack. I just warned them out. Alright. Ah, sweet. Yeah, who really cares about stability at this point, right? Alright. So we're gonna have to go to Liberator Capital, is what this one comes down to. Like, simply put, we have to... Oh, no. Why do you have to do mean things to me, Deli? Were you not loved as a child? I don't blame your parents because you're like a pretty terrible person. But still. Alright. Can hopefully just consolidate at this point. Like so. And free the capital. That's the dream at least. And yeah. Other side of that coin is that Deli leaves. Nope, they're not gonna leave me alone. They like screwing with me too much. Whatever. Bring it. I mean, their cavalry are the, like, changers there, but they now have the combined arms malice. And get wrecked. Get out of my land. Okay. Yeah. I'm not dealing with that war exhaustion. Diplopower is overrated. See, once I get my capital back, Yep, that's fine. Gore's out of this, which means I just have, I just need my capital back like so. Now I can go and wreck Deli. Interesting. Okay. That's not the worst thing in the world that could have happened. I mean, we consider that, Timurids have... Yeah. Timurids, you're more than welcome to come and wreck Deli for me. You're not allowed to get anything from Deli. You're more than welcome to wreck them for me. Oh, this is going to be painful when Deli joins in. Okay. Way to be, Molten. Way to be. Alright. So, Temerits, how goes wrecking Delhi for me? Apparently not very well. What's up? What time is it? Time for me to go to bed. I really want to finish this war, it's a problem. Oh, Delhi. Why? Why do you have to be so mean to me, Delhi? Why? Oh, hey, I don't have a leader. That's probably a problem. What's my heir? 232. It's really not better. What are you? You're upset. Alright. So yes, vassal, attach. Okay. So yes, I just need to go carpet siege Delhi before the Temerits can take anything off them. It's probably not gonna happen, but it's a dream. Okay. Here we go. So, you glorious guys. Here's what we're gonna do. You go there. Don't I still have military access with you? Yes. So, why can I not? Okay. Alright. I understand why that happened, but it's because I have to leave that province. Probably? Why? Okay. Well, we can get the war goal and go from there. Fortunately, since you don't connect land at all, then there's not much I can really do here. I really don't even care about your vassal. Come on. What is my vassal even doing? That's the real question. What is my vassal even doing? Alright. So if I take Lahore, the dream is that I can take a lot of other provinces for myself. Because the thing is, there's a dream that I could core. I should be able to core it because of my vassal, but I'm not sure. Like, I'll be able to core it because of my vassal. I'm not sure if the game is actually going to let me take it for myself. Okay. Good. My vassal's finally attached to me, which means this siege is going to go fast. Which is fine with me. Alright. Yeah, there's nothing we can do. But yeah, I had to be ready to act as soon as the siege falls. Because, yeah, we're going to need to beat the Temerids to Delhi itself. That's the dream, at least. Go always build my economy up after this. Alright. So, you need to run down to Delhi. Split in half. And you go there. And past this point. Alright. Alright, here we go. Okay, here we go. Just gotta beat the Timurids, and that's all that matters. Because yes, the Timurids are not allowed to have my land. I mean, if I can't take it off the bat, if I can't take it this war, what I have to do is give the land to my vassal. Bangladesh is free. Awesome. So Lahore is something I want. But my vassal's got cores on it, so... Yep, because the game is wonky like this. So here's what I'm gonna have to do. Yeah. Alright. Gonna have to do is conquer Delhi. As well, the unfortunate part of this is that we have to occupy the territory to request it. Because, well designed, that's a not quite so well designed feature. Oh well. Now, if you're, honestly, I don't need to pay for these guys, and I really can't afford them, so get lost. And the dream is that with this war... Yeah, I did not think that through. I did not think that one through at all. Oh well. We will, I need to take that back, but it's okay. We're just going to need to, okay, lost my claim on that, unfortunately, but it is what it is. Got to build ourselves a regular infantry. Desiege this province, and send these guys on their merry way to Delhi's capital. So I'm gonna need, decent amount of troops for that one. Do I have enough to afford Merc? Probably. Yes. Awesome. Then I can barely deal with this. Timurids of War again, who cares? Send fabricate claim on Thada. Okay. Oh my god. Seriously, Delhi? This is what you do with your life. Pathetic. Alright. They're about to get stomped there. Important thing is I can liberate my siege here, and then Delhi can hopefully leave me alone. It's the dream, at least. Really appreciate if Delhi would just leave me alone. But yeah. Okay. Alright.
And I can't really afford it in the long run, but I can afford it now. That's what really matters. And yeah. Let's liberate this, and most important of all, we can just hopefully siege this up. All we really want to do is siege Delhi's one province. Well, they have two provinces left, but still. Yeah. There we go.
But yeah, I'm gonna have a very rebellious vassal as a result of this, unfortunately.
And it's gonna be, I don't know, if I do it this way, it's gonna be a while before I can. This is problematic, because I would really want to take this stuff for myself, but I have to integrate Punjab before I can actually form the Mughals at that point. I don't know, they're gonna be a lot richer than I will be, unfortunately. Because it's all very rich land. Yeah, diplo power I don't care about. I cared about the other two. So yeah, I'm gonna call it a night on this, because I wanted to go to bed before now, but I wanted to play this war out, so I didn't leave it quite as much of a cliffhanger. Previous run is doing a bit better before I foolishly went toward the Timurids. This run, I foolishly went toward the Timurids, but managed to make it work out in the end anyways. I mean, I could give these two provinces to my vassal, which gives them like a solid 50 develop, like near 50 development. Ugh. Then I go to war for these. Gosh, these are hard decisions, man. Very hard decisions to make. Oh well. We'll figure it out. Anyways, have a good night, and see you later. Oh, and my normal spiel. If you like the stream, please hit that follow button. Like the YouTube videos. Like and subscribe. Need to get a hold of me. Always appreciate feedback. Gillibear on Twitch. Hero Glod on YouTube. Glod1 on Reddit. Frogbait on Paradox Plaza forums. Have a good night, guys, and catch you later. Bye.